I read a fair amount of novels and history. I think novels, a great novel is just, you can lose yourself in it. And my wife had been saying to me for years, you really should read Madame Bovary, which I never had. I read a little bit of it in French, but not the whole book. So I read it in English a couple of years ago. That's one of the most fabulous books I've ever read. And it's not what I would call useful. There are like, you know, 8 pages of descriptions of the leaves on a lane that somebody's walking down in central France after a rain. But I just love that.
I feel right now, particularly because I'm living such a nonfiction life, fiction is very helpful. Fiction, good. I think Americans in general don't appreciate the depth, how much to savor in like real literature, right? Books like The Age of Innocence,
yes,
which I like read every couple years along with Jane Austen. You know, they just feed you. So I find novels really. Right now I'm reading something called, I don't remember, something about Eleanor Oliphant.
Oh,
isn't the title?
Right.
Yeah, have you read that?
Good.
Yeah. Should I finish it?
Yeah.
The only other ones I tend to read fiction often is by Philippa Gregory.
Mm-hmm.
And I do that because she writes, for everybody who's not familiar with her, and my daughter just got her autograph last month.
Oh, really?
Is because my daughter reads them. Mm. And she wants to be a creative writer. And she's taking a gap year right now to finish her novel, which she wrote. And she parallels her writing, not style, but thoughts. You know, what would have happened if King Henry VIII had not become king?
Speculative fiction?
Yes, so it's creative fiction. And so in the last year or so, she had a new book out. I haven't read it, but the one before that I read this past year.